So what do we do now? So we're supposed to... Directions say what?
Whatever they say on your phone, because I'm tying back my hair, because safety first.
So we have to... Says we have to heat the water, mm-hmm. oil, and food coloring until boiling. Add salt and stir until dissolved. Remove from heat and stir in flour and cream of tartar. Stir until well mixed. Remove from pan and knead. Be careful. It's hot.
Hot!
I would suggest wearing the rubber gloves while you knead. Oh, okay. We have some rubber gloves. Yeah. It's stored in a tight container. All right, cool.
All right.
So I don't know how much this will make, right? We'll need like a lot.
No, it's going to be fine. Like okay. One batch will be totally fine.
All right, so we need a pot. And we need to add water. So we can do that. That's hot. Okay, what else do we need?
Okay. Hot water. Heat water, oil, and food coloring.
Heat water, food.
Coloring and oil.
Food coloring and oil. Okay.
4 tablespoons of oil.
4 tablespoons? Is there like a spoon? Oh, here it is.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah.
Tablespoon.
So 4 tablespoons. And how much salt? Because I can't remember anything.
Memory of
instructions.
Memory of a goldfish.
Yes. Been away from school for so long.
Yes, exactly.
One cup of salt.
All the salt.
1 cup of salt.
Maybe we should have done the salt before the water. So.
No. Yeah, we can do it over there. That's true, but. What happened?
Nothing.
What?
I'm being dramatic.
Oh, you're just being dramatic?
I'm just being dramatic.
Drama.
How nervous can we make Mr. Mario? Very.
You are making me nervous. Oh, you do have the cup. You already have the cup.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Use the cup to measure the water.
1 cup of salt.
I am curious to see how well this works. Because I get various batches. I get some really good and some not so good. I'm curious to see.
Wait, this is non-toxic. You can eat it. You can do the old taste test.
Yeah, I teach kindergarten. We have to be safe. Gotta account for all the situations.
You mean don't eat it?
Yes.
Okay, don't eat it. It probably won't taste good anyway.
No.
Salt. Look, I'm still pouring salt. How long does it take to pour salt?
Apparently this long. Actually longer, because you're not even halfway there.
Oh my god. We should be like a cartoon where you just grab the bottle and go toss.
That would be perfect.
Thank God for the magic of editing, yeah. No, 10 hours later. Oh, I'm totally doing the editing that. 10 hours later.
Do you not have enough salt?
No, it's just a lump. We need more salt.
It seems like you hooligans. Getting salt all over your counter. You also have a mountain. Eek! I fix it later.
Okay, so this goes into the
Pot of Doom.
Pot of Doom.
Wait, no!
Yeah, huh?
Heat water, oil, and food coloring until boiling. Then add salt. We already messed it up.
Dang it! And that was the only salt we had. Okay, it's okay.
Experimentation.
I'm experimenting. Apparently we screwed up the recipe already.
Gosh dang it!
Gosh dang it.
Oh well, we tried. Oh, you all get the idea. You're big kids.
Yeah, seriously. Come on now.
Now.
See, this is why I have you guys, like, at school, they'd be like, no. I was like, oh, right. All right. Yeah. I missed a step. Okay.
We added salt instead of food coloring, but we can still add the food coloring.
I got too excited.
You did. That's okay, though. I just didn't read ahead.
And readings have to battle, that's why I say.
Because I teach kindergarten, it takes us 15 to 20 minutes to follow step one, so I have 15 to 20 minutes to read step two.
I should be in kindergarten and learn how to read instructions then, because I can't. I should be able to read step one. One thing.
Oh, no.
One thing.
They don't read step one. I read over step one and tell them what to do. And but we need to add the food coloring, though.
Okay, we need to add the food. What color do you want to do?
Ooh, I don't know. What color do you want to do? I like all the colors.
I like the... We should make yellow.
We should make yellow?
Yeah. Which ones do have you used before? We're almost out of red. Plenty of green. Mm-hmm. No, I think yellow we need. But green, maybe. How do you ever use green?
I'm about it.
All right. Let's make green.
Green! Okay.
Well, how much green?
Mm-hmm. How much green? It's however much green we want.
Depending on how green you want?
How green do you want this Play-Doh?
Oh! Alright, hold on. I gotta move the camera before it starts melting. Melting!
Oh my gosh, the oil is making a face.
Oh yeah!
How much food coloring do we
want? I don't know.
Okay.
Hold on,
wait,
we gotta mix it.
Yes!
There's a spatula right there. I need one of those, like with the wooden spoon over there.
The wooden spoon, okay.
Oh, yeah, we're gonna dye that a certain color. That's...
What's that? No. We gonna dye it a second color?
You're gonna dye the spoon.
Mario! Do you want to convert to plastic?
I guess we could convert to plastic. Fine. No, I wouldn't. It does. Okay. I would it? Would it? Nah. No. You know what? No. Just convert to plastic. Plastic. Let's go with plastic.
Okay. Plastic?
My wife says no plastic. I mean, no wood. Wood will get changed the color. And then...
What's wrong with a green spoon?
Yeah, what's wrong with colors? You against greens? Green colors?
What do we think?
I like it. It looks like lime.
It does look kind of like limey. It looks like a science experiment, which is what we're doing.
It looks like some sort of Kool-Aid drink. Like, I really want to drink that.
Please don't.
No, I don't want
to. It's going to taste really nasty.
I know it's going to taste... I know it will taste nasty, but it looks like... I don't know, I thought it looks delicious.
Yum. So that's the color?
I guess so. Except it looks like salt. I mean, it's just pure salt.
Well, that's because we had all the salt.
You know, make that face like... like it's salty. Okay.
Stop being so salty.
It's spoiling.
It is
bleeding. 10 hours later.
Yeah. 10 more hours later.
Yeah, 10
this
more.
Took 20 hours for your teacher to make. This kid is why you followed the recipe.
Seriously. It says until boil. So. Until
boil.
Alright.
We got that boil.
Boiling now.
Okay. We added the salt already. And stir until dissolved. How do we know when the salt's dissolved?
Oh, you see those little clumps right there?
Yes.
Yeah, I think that's until they're all gone.
Ooh. Excellent. So, we stir until dissolved.
Until dissolved.
Stir!
feel it. Like, I feel the clumps. It's kind of weird.
Oh, they're sticking to the bottom?
No. Stir and feel.
Oh, yeah. Kind of like when pasta sticks to, like, the bottom of the pot. Yeah, it's weird. Like when you touch sand.
Yeah.
On the water surface. I can feel it rolling.
Yes, exactly. That's this feeling.
All right, so then it's dissolved, and then we...
Stir until dissolved.
Okay, stir until dissolved. Oh, and then I guess we're going to need some bowls, don't we? Bowls so that we can mix said liquid concoction.
Yes.
Remove from heat, stir in flour and cream of tartar.
Tartar!
What is tartar?
Google excerpt.
I know, Google excerpt.
We paused this video to bring you cream of tartar from Google. Like, y'all are crazy. I'm done with you.
We interrupt this video. Okay, so. So, we're combining all these materials to make one. You think if we sift the flour into it, it'll make it better?
I'm not sure if that makes a difference. But hey, if we're gonna test it, why not go
So it's not lumpy, you know?
True. I will say that I do sometimes get lumps in the Play-Doh, so sifting might not be a bad idea.
Oh yeah, so like you sift a little bit? Well, this is a sifter.
Play-Doh
with
Hima all over it.
I've never actually made it. I just get it and I judge it.
Like some of it, you know, it's made right. And other times I'm like, okay, this is super sticky or it's super lumpy.
It doesn't pass the test.
No. Right, what are you saying?
Okay.
Master Chef. Master Yoda and Baby Yoda.
Hold on. I think it's right. Yeah. It's starting to smell like water for like pasta. Okay, so. Should we start like adding the dough, the flour? I guess we should do it in a pot. We don't need a bowl.
First, it says remove from heat. So that would be step one.
Okay. Then we add the flour and tartar. How much tartar do we need?
Cream of tartar?
We need 4 tisps.
4 tisps.
4 tisps.
4 tisps. Alright, hold up. So we have
hot. Yeah, pot.
Oh jeez. Alright, so we're gonna have to grab the
yeast. Okay, so 4 cups of flour.
4 cups of flour.
We have the sifter.
Yeah. Wait, hold on. Probably need to use the small one. Okay. Besides, that one's wet too. So wait, this is 3/4, 2/3, half. So you want to do a cup at a time?
That makes sense to me.
So we're gonna do a cup at a time.
A cup at a time. You and these cameras.
I know. But hey, when you have to do the filming and editing by yourself, man, it's kind of hard.
True.
Now you see why the YouTubers, them YouTubers got them like...
fancy stuff.
And fancy people like walking around with them. Mm-hmm. You have like peoples. Look at this. I'm using like a peanut butter can to like hold this up.
The kids can't see that though.
Yeah, it's okay.
Our viewers.
Through the editing, magic of editing. Oh, is that? Because that was a cup, right?
It's a cup.
Oh my gosh.
Sifter.
Okay. Probably need a mixing spatula. This is hot.
Oh my gosh, this spoon.
Jeez, it crystallized. Salt crystallized.
Wild.
Do you want to mix while I, like,
sure.
Sip?
Because it's a two-man job.
It really is.
Or two people. Because, you know, I'm no man.
We need two people.
Oh my gosh. This is insane.
It started like matzo balls.
Yes!
Like, we poorly made matzo balls.
Very poor. Let me tell you, we just made matzo balls. No, that's not how you do a matzo ball.
Speaking of which, I have a mix of matzo balls. I need to make that.
Oh my gosh. Yes. Do.
I have all the necessary, like, ingredients.
All the necessary ingredients, yes.
Okay, starting to, like, I think we're gonna need more, like, food coloring, because that's gonna look really pale.
Mm-hmm.
Like pea green or, like, the nasty green.
Okay, we shall add more food coloring.
Yeah.
How many drops do you think?
I don't know, plenty. Just go for it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Looks way better.
Oh, there we go.
Wow.
Now we really have got some slime going on.
That's like green apple, like, you know, past green apple now.
Yeah. This is a slime experiment monster from Scooby-Doo right here.
Yes. Scooby-Doo slime monster.
Oh, yeah.
All right, hold up.
Nah.
So that's like... Let's see here. Yeah, I feel like you can whisk at this thing.
Oh, yeah. We're starting to get to that point where we can't whisk this, and it's like, fine.
I mean, it's clumping, but I'm probably not, like, to the...
It's
not bad, isn't it?
Yeah, it's
have you seen, like, really bad clumps before? No.
Yes, but like, this is not it. But it's also like...
Yeah.
I mean, I've made it. I don't know. It's never like, giant clump in the middle. No.
I never made it before either. I don't think I ever made like the one that you had to cook. I've only made like the one that has, what's it called? Like the one that... You don't need any cooking.
Mm. Yeah, no, that's the recipe I have. That's the recipe I gave the parents. And I go, make this! And then they ask questions,
yeah.
And I go, make this! I have no answers for you. Christina's abandoning us. She's waiting for the slime monster to pop out.
Oh, we need a tartare.
Yes.
What's the point of the tartare?
I don't know.
Right?
Learns after the fact.
It smells like garlicky onion. How much?
4 teaspoons.
Small teaspoons? Or big teaspoons?
4 teaspoons. Teaspoons.
Teaspoons, okay.
That's what a teaspoon is. A tib is a tablespoon. We have tisps and tibs.
Yeah, tibs and tips. What, 4?
4 teaspoons. Bleh.
Oh, okay. Do we have enough? Oh, no!
It's 4 teaspoons, not tablespoons. Ooh. Don't know, we'll see. Oh well.
Okay, so this is a...
That's a teaspoon?
It says right here. And by the way, flour we need? We need
2 cups!
Yeah, we only did 2 cups. No, 4 cups. We just did 2 cups.
We just did 2 cups, we need 2 more cups.
Mm-hmm.
That's the word. Those are the words.
Those are the words.
Those be the words.
We weren't really ready for this.
No.
It's so impromptu.
It is.
Let's make this. Okay.
Maybe we should have done it all at once.
Oh, because now it's like getting...
Yeah, because now it's like dough. We've got all this flour and dough.
Oh, that, I think at this point we have to like start kneading it with our hands, I guess.
I don't know. Okay. All I know is it's starting to surpass my mixing strength level.
Okay, so I'll get in there. Start mixing it. Oh, that's a lot of flour. Okay, I'm gonna put this aside here. Alright. Should I start mixing?
Get in there.
Oh, it's hot.
Really?
It really is. Holy cow. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Kids, wear gloves. Don't be like your teacher. Wear gloves.
Wear the gloves. When they said it was hot, I mean, that's like... Yeah, I should have paid attention to the bold letters that say HOT!
In all caps.
In all caps. Like, danger! Danger! Watch yourself!
Yes, exactly. But not mortal peril. Yeah. Just, second degree burns. It's fine.
Just chickity check yourself before you wreck yourself. Alright, here, you want to pour the last cup?
Pour the last cup? Aye,
yeah.
Aye.
Oh, okay, keep going. It's fine. It's just saying that one's dead.
Oh no! Excessive beeping! We're done now!
You're done? Okay. I feel like we should have made... Oh, yeah, I'm glad we added more, like, green, because look at this.
Mm-hmm.
Like, otherwise it would have been, like, this yucky pale, like, thing.
Yuckiness.
Yeah.
All right, cream of tata.
Okay. It is still hot, but, like, the flour sort of coats it a little bit, so I can only, like, toss it around.
Did you want the rubber gloves?
I think I will need the rubber gloves.
Rubber glove time.
Rubber gloves. Here, I'll get some rubber gloves in a bit.
Okay. And then... Yeah, I mean, it actually says remove from pan and knead. So, like, we're probably going to have to knead it to get all this flour and cream of tartar in there.
Okay.
And after adding the cream of tartar, it's just mixing it, and that's it.
Okay, you want to add the cream of tartar in here? Like, while we still have, like...
Sure. I shall scoop and add while you get gloves.
I'm going to separate some of this. Yeah.
Aye. Kneading the dough, he thought they wouldn't be covered in flour. Silly. Silly, silly, Mr. Mario. What's also silly is if I think I'm going to mix this, because we have surpassed that stage. It's definitely a Mario mixing jump.
Okay, clearly unprepared. So,
clearly unprepared.
Plan B, other types of gloves.
Oh my god! When you
when
you don't have rubber gloves, wear, you know, COVID-19 gloves.
Yeah.
You should.
But what if said gloves melt into my hands?
Yeah, those gloves
melt. Okay, I'm cool with it.
You should have just asked. I have rubber gloves at head home.
Well, I didn't think about this.
I thought we had them. I thought we had them. I was like, oh.
Is it still hot?
Quite. A little bit. Yeah.
Because the whole point of the rubber gloves is to help protect against the heat. That would be it. That's not going to help protect you against the heat.
It, like, sort of does. It's more manageable than it was before.
That's good. The Incredible Hulk here, ladies and gentlemen.
Just... Oh, yeah, that's pretty good.
Weirdest dough I've ever seen.
Does it look like this? It's supposed to be like this? Yeah, it's supposed to
look. Yeah.
Yeah,
it looks Never fun. Said it wasn't weird looking.
I wonder how they make it in, like, the actual factories. I guess we gotta... I never looked at the video how to make, like, how they made it's made in a factory.
I don't know.
Funny thing, of all the times I've been teaching manufacturing, I never looked up one of, like, Play-Doh. You know, the classic toys.
Yeah, yeah. You should. Hear that, kids?
Yeah, I'm gonna add it
Hold to him to it.
I'm gonna add it in the lesson there. Alright, hold up. What if I do this?
Oh my gosh. It's gonna look crazy. That's what's gonna happen here.
It's gonna look crazy.
Uh-huh. Because I don't know that a parent has done this. But
how am I baking the bread, huh?
Making the bread for the pizza.
Yeah, I'm making the bread for the pizza.
With the pesto.
It looks like pesto, yeah. It looks like pesto. It does.
Ooh, we're starting to see that other color come through. Just a little bit.
Dude, this is really satisfying. Like ASMR.
Your wife's looking at you like you're crazy.
Yeah. Just need it.
Just a little bit.
I know, right? Like ASMR. Just need it. I think, you know what? ASMR videos are kind of weird. Now that I think about it. What happened?
I just thought the spatula was going to fall on the floor.
Yeah. If anything, the camera or anything else will, like, fall.
Apparently my sound effects scare him.
Yeah, so, look at that. I mean, look, it looks cool.
It does.
But I feel like we're just going to, like, stain our hands when we play with it. If it comes out. If we're able to play with it today.
Probably. I've never used it same day, but...
It looks like gum, like chewable, like gum. Like Laffy Taffy. Look at that. I mean, it's...
No.
It's really cool.
It is. I have to say, you're mixing it a lot better than what I normally get.
Really?
Yes.
This is awesome.
You also have to consider mine is usually a, oh, make this at home with mommy, made by a 5-year-old.
Oh. I mean, that's a fun one.
Yeah, because this is a fun thing to do with kids.
Yeah. But... It doesn't come out, like, perfect, but...
Yeah, there's still lumps and clumps because you get tired mixing it.
No, it's... I'm not kidding. It, like, takes some muscle here, but... I can see that, yeah.
Gym workout.
Yeah. I'm sweating, guys. Water. I need water. Dude, this is awesome. Look at this. I think I should add more, a little bit more green.
A little bit more green?
Yeah.
Right. Where's the green?
Here.
Oh, thank you. Make me feel useful. Why don't you?
Well, do you want
like any? Lots more green? No.
just a couple drops. Like boop, one, boop. Two, three. Perfect.
Now we're finger painting.
Finger painting.
We're really in kindergarten now.
Like, honestly, like, if you guys are doing this at home with us, I mean, it's really fun. It's actually pretty damn satisfying. And honestly, I think if this works out right, like, even though we did it sort of a little bit backwards.
Right.
Like, even if you get, like, you can probably make this and then add the food coloring afterwards so you can make different colors.
Oh, yeah.
Because it worked. And just get the rubber gloves because otherwise you'll burn your hands. But no, man, it just looks really delicious. Like, I could just, like, I don't know what I expect. I expected it to taste like apple.
But green apple.
No, don't eat it. Don't eat it. It will not taste.
Just because we can eat it doesn't mean we should
eat
it.
Yeah, doesn't mean we should eat it.
10 out of 10, do not recommend.
10 out of 10. Do the kindergartners eat it?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Really great faces there. Like those first few weeks when we're going over rules and stuff. Oh, I wonder if I can do this. You can does not mean you should.
It's bursting. It tastes bad.
Yes, that's why we don't eat it.
Dang it, Billy.
Dang it, Billy. We can't use the Play-Doh today because you ate it.
Okay, this is really, like, really good quality. Like, I think we might get, like, Play-Doh run for his money, man. And this is all, like, organic.
To be fair, I also have to make a double batch of this, so...
It's non-processed.
Mm-hmm. So they're probably very tired of me by the time they're done with all this. Because they do this twice.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Well, I gotta accommodate enough Play-Doh for... 3 or 4 kids to use it at the same time.
Well, you see, you guys, if we were at school right now, like, since we're learning about manufacturing, and this is what it's about, like, mixing materials and creating things in big batches, like, I would be sharing this with you guys. Like, it would be, like, taking a lump and be like, everybody grab your own thing, and you'll have your own little containers to put it in. Because now I found a quick, easy way of making this stuff. I used to buy it all the time.
Oh, yeah.
Now it's like, it's so much better to make it. Or even just make it at school.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody just joins in. Okay, well... So I wish next year, right? A science project. Let's manufacture some Play-Doh. I should Yeah, that's a good idea. So, sorry for those of you who might not have me next year, but you'll be welcome to join us, actually. Yeah, we'll figure it out someday, you know.
Visiting day.
Visiting day, that's right, yeah. Yeah, you have to visit me first to get a pass or something, or
yeah.
I'll ask permission from our administrators.
There you go.
We're going to make Play-Doh in Mr. Castillo's class. Yay! No, actually, yeah, you have no idea how much fun we had. Like, when we were doing manufacturing, we play with the Play-Doh. Because they're, like, you know, separating, right? Combining. Forming. This is, like, forming. Mm-hmm. You're not... You're changing the shape of it. So this is awesome. I think it's all... What do you think? It's done?
It looks really good to me.
All right.
As long as you're good with the color and you're done, you know, exercising your arms. Got your gym workout in.
It's just really satisfying. I don't want to stop, like...
No, I get that. Yeah, I think it's satisfying to watch. It's like a video.
Like, try it now. It's literally so satisfying.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, mine is not nearly as satisfying to watch because I'm not nearly as strong.
But, like...
Oh, yeah.
Doesn't it feel like it's like a nice consistency?
Oh, yeah. Definitely. Like, I can see my 19 kids digging into this easily, and they'd be thrilled.
Yeah, that's so... it's really...
Just add glitter.
No, please don't. I'll find glitter, like, days after. Sometimes I come home, and I'm just like, where did I get glitter? And I haven't even been to the art... the art doesn't even have glitter. It just happens to be there somehow. Glitter.
No glitter.
Look, it's bouncy. Can't play b-ball with this thing, though.
Let the beat drop.
Let the beat drop.
It looks like a cabbage.
It does look like a cabbage.
She speaks!
Alright, so, now what?
Did just let it cool? Try?
No.
Now you don't? Okay, you don't? Here. Alright. Okay, so... I guess now clean up?
Yes.
Clean up time.
Because definitely 10 out of 10 clean up your mess. Oh, are you gonna have some people that are mad at you?
I think it's dirty. See, I don't know what the tartar does, so I guess you might not need it. I don't know.
don't know.
Google. We're done making this giant mess with Google.
Okay, I have to let this sit because it's like literally
bounded
to like the. Yeah.
Christina does not like the sound of this.
Well, I use the aluminum one.
So the purpose of cream tartar is to activate alkaline baking soda. So pretty much, generally, you combine it with baking soda and you have baking powder. So probably activate something in the flour to like make it
like
doughy.
That makes sense because it looks elastic.
That's probably where that look comes
from. Okay, so those are clean. Those right there.
These are clean.
Yeah.
Get
it. And we can go that one there.
Oh,
mm-hmm. Okay, I'm gonna leave these in water while they, like...
You know, soak.
Yeah, soak. Okay, and can you just hit the top button there?
Top button. Hold it or just click?
Just click